And now, the Hallelujah Program with Minister Deborah Jackson and Brother Daniel.
Good afternoon. I am here in the stead of Dr. Jackson and Brother Daniel. I am so glad to be here today. What a wonderful day it is. It's a beautiful day outside. The temperature is about 88 degrees, and it is pretty warm. But we are forever grateful to the Lord. I just left the Apostolic Church of America, where Pastor Lewis and the Gifted Action and People are going forth in their conference today. And what a blessing it was today. I just want to say that God moves by His Spirit. He moves the way He wants to move and how He moves. There was a young lady and a young man heard the music. They've been hearing this music. But God has been dealing with this man on the same issue, just dealing with him, letting him know how real he is and how he's been keeping him and protecting him. He said, but when he heard this music, it made him come around to the church to see where this music is coming from. And I just want to say today, that man, I didn't get his name, but him and his wife is Cambodian and he's Mexican American, but they gave their heart to the Lord today. And what a blessing that is when somebody can hear the music and want to come where that music is leading them to. And I know that was God. And we are an international church where we're all different nationalities. And God is doing just what He said He would do. Amen. And I praise Him for that. So that's what He's doing in a day and time. He's bringing people together. He's reaching out. When people are reaching out to Jesus, He's reaching out to them. That's why we often say that He is a right now God. He's moving by His Spirit. And I praise God what He's doing today in that service. And I want to say, Sister Mary, you blessed us today in that praise and worship. And that's what that young man was hearing, that praise and worship from her heart. And when we praise from our heart, God hears and honors that. Amen. And both him and his wife gave their heart to the Lord. And we had prayer there. And it was just such a beautiful service there today. It's a conference. It's Gifted People in Action, showcasing their talents and gift of what they have for the Lord. And I was caught off guard myself, and I did a little skit saying, you don't know who I really am behind the things that are going on in our lives. You don't know who we really are. And there's people out there, you don't really know who I am. But first of all, I want to be a woman of God and sharing God's goodness and how good He is to me and how He can be good to you and the things that He can provide for you. I can truly say God is a provider. He's a way maker. And He's there in the time of need when we need help. God is right there for us. And I can truly say what He is to me, He's an awesome God. So we were just sharing today, and I was able to just do a skit today, which I haven't did in years, or sometimes I could just be playing around, but I was asked to do a skit, and I think it blessed a few people. It blessed me because that's something that came up that I had never shared before. You can share from your heart the things that your experience would have happened to you. Amen. So that's what happened to me today at the Gifted People in Action. We have a lot of people that are gifted. And I want to encourage more people to come out. When we give addresses of events that are going on, we would love to see your faces there to come and support, because it will bless you. It will encourage you to see what Gifted Action and People are doing. So they are on a mission. They're doing something positive. Great speakers there, and I was truly blessed this morning. Amen. But I just wanted to, I also want to give a shout out to Granny. I did go see her last week. And this week, she's supposed to be getting a cast on her ankle. It was her ankle that she broke. And we just thank God for Granny that she is getting better and better each day. And I can just see the healing power of God in her life, that He's healing her. And she is she's in such a great spirit, Ron. She is. And she said she can't wait to come back and see you, Ron, because she said she wants to bless Ron. She wants to put something. I said, Granny, that is such a blessing that you're thinking of Ron Ron, what you think of that? Granny's thinking of you. Well, amen. Yeah, she was telling me that she's thinking of Ron. And today she have all her grandsons around there just helping her out and doing good things for her. Amen. She got grandsons that cook for her and just her every need, whatever she needs, you know, they're there to help her.
Well, I've been blessed every day, so I'm blessed to be alive. I'm blessed to have this job. I'm blessed to have my own career and stuff like that. So, I've just been blessed for many opportunities and that comes in my way.
Amen.
And I appreciate Granny for blessing me, even though she's not in a good state right now. But
hopefully she
recovered from this and hope she gets better. And that's all I have to say.
You know what, Ron? I think she's going to be so delighted to hear that you had some encouraging words to say to her. She's going to be excited about that, to hear that you said something, giving her a shout out. Amen. Dr. Jackson, we love you, and get well soon. And Pastor Daniel, I left him at the Gifted People in Action, and he is have his jury out, Majesty. Majesty is doing great there. And we just want to invite more people to come out and check out Majesty. Majesty is a ministry that God has blessed Brother Daniel with, and it is growing. And we thank God for the growth and the things that it is doing, growing, having some jewelry with God's word on it. What a blessing that could be. What a blessing that is that you're out somewhere and you're thinking, wow, I'm just covered in Jesus with the word of God, either in a necklace or a bracelet or a ring, or however, even the dog tag they have, there's something positive on the dog tag that you can wear, just positive in your life. Some of them says, I'm a man of God, I'm a woman of God. I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. This is just some of the scriptures that there's a friend that stick closer than a brother. These are some of the scriptures that are on Majesty's jury, you know, amen, that we can talk about it, and it could become a part of your life, a part of our lives when we represent Majesty. Amen. And Majesty is being represented today in a great way. Praise God. And we're just enjoying hearing more and more about the Word of God through all kinds of ways, you know. And God is blessing us, and He's just doing great things here in the city of Los Angeles. We're getting a football team in Inglewood, the Rams. Are you excited about that, LaRon?
Well, it's surprising to have the Los Angeles Rams here.
Yeah.
But they're in the Inglewood Stadium, which is the Forum.
Yes.
And I think they should be called Inglewood Rams. But congratulations on your first win, even though you lost last week.
Okay.
But yeah. Congratulations.
Okay, so you're a sports fan of the Rams, okay? I just know they're going to bring a lot of revenue here in the city of Inglewood.
Well, actually, I'm a fan of Patriots, so okay. We're 3-0. We're undefeated right now.
All right. You representing. Amen. So, you know, we can always talk a little sports here at the Hallelujah Program. There's so much going on. There's sports. There's conference going on. Yesterday, I had the opportunity to go to a conference. It was called the Quake 2016. And it's going on today. It would really, really bless me. It was great speakers there. The women, the praise and worship was just awesome. And testimonies and sharing and different words going forth. I was truly blessed. I was determined that I was going to get there at that Shrine Auditorium yesterday. I got there. It started at 9. I got there about 10:30. Couldn't find the place. It's all entangled with the USC. It kept locking me in, going around and circled the university. And I finally found a parking space, and I had to park so far. But I got there, and I was blessed with a great word. Things are turning around for us in our lives. That was the mess. Things are turning around. Whatever it is in your life that you need God to do something, it's turning around. Amen. And then the lady came that was speaking today. She was saying the same thing. Things are turning around in our lives today. So that was just a confirmation. God gives us confirmation through other people. And that can be such a great blessing when you can receive that. You know, and I just received that through the power of the Holy Ghost. God is turning things around. He's turning things around in your life, LaRon. He's turning things around in my life, Pastor Daniel's life. He's turning things around in Granny's life, Dr. Jackson. He's bringing us another phase in our lives. You know, he is blessing us as never before. And I'm just receiving the blessing that God has for me with open arms and saying, Lord, here am I. Wherever you want me to be, what do you want me to do? Amen. I have entered another class called the Master Life, and it's such a blessing. It's every Monday night. Amen. From 7 to 9. But what a blessing. It helps you develop your own personal relationship with Christ and where you're spending your devotion time, your quiet time, and you can share others, but knowing that Christ is in the center of our lives. He's right there in the center. And the more knowledge you become of the Lord, the more knowledge you can become where you can be able to share with other people the knowledge that you have learned and knowing more of the Lord, more of God, having more of God in your life. And I was noticing that the teacher said that when you finish this class, you'll be able to stand just like I am and teach the same concept that I'm teaching. I say, Lord, I praise you because, you know, what I love about this class, it helps you memorize the scriptures that you need to memorize every week for your class. And knowing that you can have you have a prayer partner, you have a prayer partner in your class, knowing who you are and knowing what you want from God and knowing that you are he's the vine and we are the branches. Praise God, knowing where we are, where we stand. And so this is such a help, and it's called the Master Life. And what a blessing it is. So we all need mastering. We have to master our life one way or another. We have to master our life, making sure that we're on the right path of life, going the right direction. And I want to be on that right path of living for God and going the right way, of the right direction. We're here. You're on the right path, and all of a sudden you make a quick right or left. But you got to get back in and say, I'm staying on the path of where God has put me on. And God has put us on so many different paths of righteousness. And I just want to stay there. I just want to be who God is calling for, you know, in the church today. We encounter so many people, homeless people, and people that's discouraged. But if we can just give them a word of encouragement in our daily lives, if I can help somebody along the way, if I can just say an encouraging word to help you and say, hey, it's going to be okay. Be encouraged. I love you with the love of the Lord in my heart. I love you. Amen. With the love of the Lord. And that's what we have to show, genuine love toward one another, not fake love. You ever seen anybody show fake love? You know, they hug you, and you know that's not a genuine hug. But, you know, I want to be the one to have that genuine love for you and showing it, you know. Amen. Showing the love of God. Praise God. And, you know, I was just thinking today how we make it in this life one day at a time, one step at a time. And so the new converts that came and received the Lord today, they need a Bible. They need a time of devotion. Start having quiet time. Start beginning to pray and seek God. So praying and reading God's word go hand in hand. And that's where you begin to grow. And you begin to see growth in your life. Other people begin to see the growth in your life through what God has done. Yes, and right now we just want to have a song that LaRon's going to play for us that's on our heart and that's something that we, you know, want to just be a blessing to someone out there in the TV internet land. And I just want to say, hello to Mama Dorothy. And she came in and she surprised her son, Bo, on his 53rd birthday. I want to say hello to Bo and many birthdays to come, and may God richly bless you, Bo. Amen. I was so glad to see your mother. She surprised you, and She is such a beautiful woman and beautiful woman of God. I was looking forward to speaking with her today, and I know she will come and be with me soon. And when she come to be with me, she's going to be talking on marriage. And she has been married for 53 years. So, you know, she has something really to share with us. And I'm excited to just to hear her, what she's going to be sharing with us. And she's such an encouragement. She's such a, just have a beautiful glow about herself. And when she share, such a pretty lady. Amen. And she has two beautiful daughters. And I would say that's Tina and Sean Robinson. Amen. Actually, that's Tina Robinson Wade. Praise God. We just love her and love that family. Amen. And looking forward to seeing them soon. So, Ron, we just thank you for this song you're playing for us. What is it called?
Well, everybody heard the song. It's by Vashawn Mitchell. It's called Nobody Greater.
Oh, amen. Nobody Greater. Praise God. Thank you for picking that song, Ron. That's a beautiful one. Amen.
The highest mountain, looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Went down into the deepest valley, looked all around, down there, couldn't find nobody. I went across the deep blue sea, couldn't find one to compare to your grace, your love, your mercy. Nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater, nobody greater, no, nobody greater than you. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater. Nobody greater, nobody greater than you. Nobody can heal like you can. Oh, most holy one, you are the great I am. Awesome in all your ways, and mighty is your hand. You are he who carried out redemption's plan. You are he who carried out redemption's plan.
Searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody.
Nobody greater. Nobody greater, Jesus.
Nobody greater than you.
Search all over.
Search all over.
Couldn't find no.
Couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low. Still couldn't find nobody.
Nobody great. Body great.
Nobody. Greater than you.
Come on, lift those hands for real in here. Come on. Nobody greater. Nobody greater, Jesus.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater. Nobody greater.
nobody greater, no.
Nobody greater than you.
Now lift those hands, singers, and let's just give him the glory. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Couldn't find nobody.
Nobody.
There you lift your hand and say that with us tonight. Come on, nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody greater than you.
Nobody like you, Jesus. Nobody greater than you, God.
Nobody greater.
Oh.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Everyone in the building, just sing that tonight. That's what we came to say. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
No matter where you look or where you
nobody
go.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Angels bow before you. Heaven and earth adore you. Nobody.
Nobody greater.
We came to lift you up.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater.
Nobody greater than you.
Come on, everybody in the building singing. Nobody greater.
Nobody greater. Nobody greater. What a song. That's a praise and worship to me because I know truly in my heart there is nobody greater than the love of God. Nobody greater. You can search all over. I mean, you can search in all the wrong places until you can find that nobody's greater. You can be high and low, but there's nobody greater than God. Amen. I found him to be such an awesome person in my life. And having spending that quiet time with God, so important. I'm learning. We can think we're so busy in life doing this and doing that. But once we can take out that time and say, this is going to be my quality time. This is going to be my special time with God. Amen. And that's my endeavor. That's my endeavor. To be in spending quality time with the Lord as we continue to grow where he wants us to grow, to be where he wants us to be, and how we can share with other people. Amen. And we have to quit searching in all the wrong places for God. You know, he's at the right places where we need him. And he just wants us to share with other people about his goodness, what he can do. How he can answer a prayer. And I just studied thinking about the young man, how that he was saying today that God has preserved his life and has saved his life and has kept him from all danger and just protected him. He could have been dead, but it was God always speaking to him. And that's why he was able to really make that transition today, come into that church. And he just fell on his knees, you know, and his wife fell on his knees with him. And they began to receive the Lord in their heart. And that was the first time that they ever said the sinner's prayer and invited God and invited the Lord into their heart. And that's what they did today. And I just said, Lord, I thank you because I know that I'm going to see these two people just grow in you because they're hungry, they're searching, they're looking. Just like that song would say, I've searched all over, high and low. But when you're ready, God knows when you're ready. And you know too when you're ready. And that you've been at your end's width. That, hey, I don't want to go any further. I want this guy that you're talking about. I want the Lord in my life. I want change. I'm looking for change. And I want to know, let you know today, these people were looking for change in their lives. And we were able to bless them today with the word of God. Amen. And they're praying and receiving God with gladness, ready. Amen. The labors are few, but the harvest is ripe. Amen. I thank God because the harvest is truly ripe. That let us know today that the harvest was ripe. But was the labors few, but the labors were ready to receive them. And that's what happened today. Amen. So let's just keep going stronger and stronger in the Lord. And we're so blessed with our Hallelujah program. It's growing, and we're continuing to looking at the numbers. They're seem like they're growing. Amen. They're growing in numbers. Let's keep tuning in to the live streaming, listening to the Hallelujah program and seeing what you can get today and how that God can bless you. And I thank God for the future of many people coming and sharing their testimonies and sharing what God has done for them. Amen. Because we realize that God is a God that never faileth, and He's a God of love. And we overcome by the words of our testimony. We, as you come in to the Hallelujah program and share the good news and what God is doing for you, because He's doing marvelous and great things in our lives as we speak today. Amen. Praise God. And I just want to say I am blessed and I am highly favored of the Lord today. And Ron, I just thank God for this segment. I thank God for you today, and I thank God for what He's doing. He's just growing us, you know. He's growing us. It may not seem like it, but He is. You know, sometimes when I'm teaching Sunday school, and maybe a few of them out there, I look at that audience like I'm teaching to 5,000 people or more, because I feel it in my spirit what God is doing, how we're growing, how we're developing, and being what God is calling us to be. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hello?
Oh, God is good.
This is the Hallelujah program. How can I help you?
Yes. Amen. Amen. We praise God. We're going to end right now, and we just thank God for His love. The precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Now we have love.